Hopefully, give you a little bit of background, as you heard from Rose, this has been in the works for a year and a half, and we've looked at other cities and towns, Boston and Cambridge and Worcester and Chelsea. But what seems to be appropriate in Northampton, as the solicitor pointed out.
Should you make the announcement that they're having audio video recorded?
Okay, so I believe that audio video now is working.
Okay.
So just to make that announcement.
Thank you. It seemed appropriate to treat this, the different areas that we have relationships with employers from different branches of government, which is why the mayor instituted or adopted a couple of executive orders that dealt with procurement and that dealt with tips, and that the city council has a small number of licenses that we administer, and we actually passed an order that the solicitor referenced. And I have a copy of that that would be helpful for you to have as well for your discussion. And the thought was that this would be an entire package with the executive order, the council order, and then a call to the license commission, and we also calling to the CPC to deal with how community preservation funds are allocated. So I'll stick around too for any other questions that you might have of me.
Question for Councilor Conley. What is the city council doing with respect to those licenses that you folks control? I know taxi cabs, for example.
Yeah. So what we did was we took the language that most of the cities and towns were adopting around licenses generally, and we applied that to the number of licenses that we also, for those, they may be employers if they're a taxi cab, they may hire drivers, but they also have to certify that they don't have wage and hour violations. So it's that simple certification and an application, and then the option, as the solicitor pointed it out, for the wage bond or wage insurance for someone who has an adjudicated fine.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Anyone else? No. Okay, with that, we'll move on. Application for change of manager for Bashir Inc., VBO Hugo's.
Point of information.
So for 315 Pleasant Street, Northampton, request approval of Form 43.
Just a point of information. I wanted to know if the chair is going to finish public comment.
Oh, is there still one?
I do believe there's a gentleman who was here for public comment who has nothing to do with the
whip. We're going to actually end this.
Yeah.
Okay. That's what we had said earlier on. Sorry about that. Okay. Yeah. So you can tell us, there's no information. For short-term all-alcohol Greater Northampton Chamber of Commerce, 19 Strong Avenue parking lot, Northampton, the annual chamber auction, May 5th, 2017, 6 to 10:30 p.m. Yeah. So is this the annual, what are they called?
Spring Swizzle, yes. On Cinco de Mayo this year.
Oh, my daughter's birthday. It'll keep me from spending too much.
I'll remind you, but you have a birthday to pay for. So this will be our fourth year, holding it here at the Eastside Grill, and our fourth year applying for the permit with you all. We work with the Parking and Transportation Department to close up the parking lot for that day and return it the next morning. And I always make sure that the police, Jody Casper and John Carvelich, are aware the event is going on, so if they can just have that for the beat cops around, but I'm happy to say we've not had any problems.
And last year you had valet parking?
We had valet parking, and we will be offering that again.
Okay, so I guess there's been a discussion about some complaints of lack of parking that day for other surrounding businesses.
Well, we worked last year, the year before there had been, and last year we met individually with those businesses. One was a Visa and Local Burger to make the valet parking available to their customers that night. They advertised it ahead of time, and we're happy to do that, and will do that again this year.
Okay, so you've solved.
Yeah, yes. And we met with them after the event last year, and they were all pleased with it. So I think that was a good solution.
Okay, great. Is everything else in order?
I will make a motion to approve the application for short-term all alcohol for the Greater Northampton Chamber of Commerce Swizzle event at 19 Strong Ave on May 5th.
Second that. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Thank you all.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Where's the event tonight?
Verizon in the back, up in the Big Y parking lot.
Okay.
Head in there now. See you.
Aye.
Thanks.
Are you guys going to be discussing more of the Fair Employment Resolution?
Yes.
Okay, so after, all right, just wondering if I should
speak
up.
So number 8 is canceled or postponed until April 1st, so we can skip that. Number 9, application for short-term wine and malt license for Click Workspace Inc., 9.5 Market Street, Northampton. A Click Music Concert number 3, date and time, March 23rd, 2017, 6 to 10 p.m. Hi.
And there's two others as well.
Oh, there is? Oh, yeah, okay. Oh, so Feed the Soul fundraiser, dates April 13th, 2017, 5 to 9. And Click Music Concert number 4, April 29th, 6 to 10. Sure, can you go ahead and tell us your name, please?
I'm Allison Quain. I'm the director of Click Workspace. We have been running a small music series this winter, and it's been going well, so we're just looking for the next two concerts to have beer and wine licenses. And then on the 13th, we're hosting an art opening, which is also serving as a fundraiser for their survival center. I believe the wine and beer will simply be served at that event, but we just need coverage for it.
Okay.
And we'll have catering.
Any questions?
Do you use the same person to serve for each of
them? Usually it's me.
Oh, okay.
We also have a board member who's a caterer and tip certified. For the fundraiser in April, she has some colleagues that we'll be bringing in as well from that community.
Okay. And could you tell us basically where the alcohol is served? What's the entrance and the egress?
Sure. We just have one entrance from the front of Market Street, and we have an emergency access in the back, but that's not an entrance. And we do all of our hosting on the first floor in our event space, which is basically just our open space workspace with all the desks taken out of it. So it's right there on street level. And it can seat about 100, a little more with just mingling and standing room.
All right, so you will be one of the servers, and are you tip certified?
It's either me or, yes, I'm on my second round now. it's either me or our board member. Both of us have our information on file with the city.
Any other questions?
I have no other questions.
Would you like to make a motion?
I will make a motion motion to approve the application for short-term wine and malt license for Click Workspace for March 23rd, April 13th, and April 29th.
I'll second that motion.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Thank you. Number 10, request for change of manager for UNI Inc. DBA Moshi Moshi. Moshi Moshi. 4 Main Street, Northampton. Request for form.
Do you know who's going
Can you state your name, please?
My name is Jeremy Lee. I am with the UNI Incorporated DBA Moshi Moshi.
No, we have it, but I didn't.
Mm-hmm. I just want to make sure we have everything. Is there anything else you need, Cindy?
I don't think so.
Everyone's TIP certified?
Yep, all their servers are TIP certified, even I am.
Okay. Right. I don't have any questions.
I'll make a motion to approve the change of manager. Uni Inc. doing business as Moshi Moshi.
I second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Thank you, Mr. Lee.
Thank you.
Thank you. Number 11, application for short-term wine and malt, W&L Retail LLC, DBA, Jackson Connor, 150 Main Street, Best Buddies Fashion Show, April 13th, 5:30 p.m. to 7:30 p.m.
Hello, everyone.
Hello.
Hey, how are you?
All right, how are you?
Good.
Good to see you. I'm William Bredell. I'm the owner of Jackson and Connor over on the second floor of Thorne's Marketplace. This will be our eighth year doing the Best Buddies Fashion Show, which is an awesome fundraiser for Best Buddies of Massachusetts. And we usually raise a nice little bit of money for them, so that's a good thing. We like to serve beer and wine only at the event.
Who do you have pouring?
It'll be Heather Beck, who is a TIP certified server.
Okay.
And yeah, her information should be on.
Okay.
How many years have you been doing this now?
This will be number 8.
Wow.
This will be number 6 or 7 for me.
Good.
That's cool. Number 7. Oh, yeah.
Any questions?
It's a great event.
Any questions?
Nope. Any questions?
I'll make a motion. I move to approve the application for short-term wine and malt license for Jackson and Connor for their Best Buddies fundraiser on April 13th.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Thank you.
Thanks so much.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Best
appreciate
of luck with your event.
Thank you. Thank you.
Okay.
Awesome. Thank you.
Bye.
Thanks a lot.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Okay. 12, application for short-term wine and malt license, Academy of Music, 274 Main Street. The event, an evening with dogs, March 14th, 2017, 7:30 to 10:30 p.m.
And bluegrass concert?
Yeah, if you are.
And then bluegrass concert by Signature Sounds, March 11th, 2017, 7:30 to 10:30 p.m. And Trey and Anastasio concert, 7:30 to 10:30 p.m. And looks like one more.
What date?
Yeah.
What's the date on the Trey Anastasio concert?
The 7th.
7th?
Yes.
March?
Yes. And then there's one with the Tommy Emmanuel, which is
that's March 5th, yeah, from 7:30 to 10, so. Is there a
what?
Yes,
sir.
You have your servers in line? And
yes, I am the server, as are my 2 to 3 other servers. They're all on staff at the academy, though I am on site and usually in the quarter for all of these.
Okay.
You guys do a good job, so we really appreciate that it being same old, same old.
Oh, right.
So do we.
You keep booking great acts. So
yeah,
yeah, we're trying.
Yeah,
trying.
Every month it gets bigger and bigger, it looks like.
Our best.
Want to make a motion?
You want this motion?
Sure, I'll make a motion to approve the application for short-term wine and malt license for the Academy of Music on the four events, dates, and times specified. Are they requesting
one? Yeah, they requested.
And I would also make a motion to approve such requested fee waiver.
I second the motion.
All in favor?
Aye.
Thanks, everybody.
Thanks.
Okay, 13, so that ends our business meeting. So approval of minutes for November 4th, December 2nd, 2016, as well as January 4th, January 9th, 2017.
November was, what are we doing, November's?
Sure, I was gonna say, I'm gonna recuse myself from voting on the January meeting since I wasn't here.
I have a question.
Abby?
Conversations, not to be punitive, but to ask him to come back and explain to us why what is actually taking place differs so markedly from what he represented to both of you.
And they may not, I don't know, I haven't been in there a little bit, so I don't know if they're done with their meeting, because they're moving so much around.
So I think before next meeting.
It could be temporary.
Yeah. So before next meeting, I'll move the store again, and if you'd like to do so.
Yeah.
And I'm following him in the meantime.
I think that would make sense.
Yeah. Okay, so we have approval.
I'll make a motion to approve the minutes that I was present at, which would be for the November 4th and the December 2nd meetings of the commission.
Okay, and I'll second that.
All in favor?
Aye. And I'll make a motion to approve the January 4th and 9th 2017 meetings.
I'll second that.
All in favor? Aye.
Aye.
Okay, great. All right, so new business. I believe there's a gentleman here who wants to talk about a neighbor of Obisa Tapas.
Hi. Hi, basically a noise complaint.
Can you state your name, please?
David Simmons. I live at 15 and a half Strong Ave. Our building's a butt. And last Thursday night, they played till 20 after 1. And I've already confronted them a few times. It's 1 o'clock. They're interrupting. I can't sleep. I'm 15, 20 feet away from a PA system. Last 2 weeks ago, I called Benson. I go, please come upstairs and listen to what I have to look. He's never there. Benson is the manager, like on paper. He's never there. John's there. And 3 weeks ago, I asked John. It was so loud, my windows are rattling. I have a picture on my phone of socks keeping my windows from rattling. There's just no sound barrier whatsoever. And this is the third time I've been here. The first time, Sebastian, I wanted to be a good neighbor. You know, the guy's working hard. And he convinced me he was gonna do everything. But I asked John, the manager, at 1 o'clock or so, 12:30, please come upstairs and listen to what I have to, no one will come upstairs and listen, they won't. I don't know what else I can do. I called the cops last Friday night. Do you recommend I call again tomorrow night, and then I call Friday?
Can you tell us what the result of the police?
I think Cindy has the thing. They just said verbal warning given. And do I call the police tomorrow? I mean, do I come here again next Wednesday?
What is their schedule?
They're normally, you know, not every, they skipped a few week bad weather a few times, but it's Thursday, Friday, Saturday. They play music, and they're all 20 after, come on, you know, Friday morning to, yeah, and you know, I have to work in the morning.
Yeah.
And so it's literally like they're mentally destroying me. I was trying to be so, as a good neighbor, you know, now it's past that point, it's like, can you shut them down, you know? And I'd hate being like that.
Well, question, do you know this gentleman who apparently is effectively managing, but it's not the name?
John is the cook.
Do you know his last name?
No, I don't.
That he serves as a cook?
Yeah, because I kept on confronting him, and then Sebastian, the original manager, said, you're talking to the wrong guy, talk to me. And he convinced me right over here, that which is a big mistake, that I'm going to take care of this, I'm going to take care of that, we're going to do that, and he was gone like a month later. Then Benson came in as the new manager. He's never there.
Benson is
the new manager who's like kind of absentee. I keep on going, I've been down in that, I won't go in there anymore. I've been down there a dozen times. Can you turn it down? Can you turn it down? I mean, would you guys know if you look up, I have a decimal, I downloaded. What is, you know, if it's even on record, what can I do, you know, past the point of, is there a,
I don't know. I'm not sure of decibel laws.
Yeah, either am I, you know.
But I do know that the one, there is.
I think so, yeah.
And I'm sure
there is. One restriction that we definitely know of is the time.
Right.
So.
And if they keep on going past. John's oblivious. He's just in the corner. He's got a drink in front of him all the time, whether it's fruit juice or alcohol. Don't know.
That's
but he's just,
besides the
point. I know what, yeah. Draw the point of it. It's just, it's a nuisance.
Right.
Well, you know, since you've tried to be a good neighbor.
This has been going on since September.
I understand, and I'm going to ask my fellow commissioners whether they feel the way I do, that conversations are important. I think that the person who is designated on our records as being the manager needs to come and talk with us.
I wish he was here. I thought he was going to, I don't know, I wish he was here. You know, I've tried so many times.
Well, this is how you get it here.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah.
So now it's going to be
what we can do.
I see these people all the time. They're my neighbor. Now I'm like uncomfortable.
Right.
You know, like being uncomfortable next to your neighbor. It's not a real good feeling. I wasn't brought up like that.
Can you also call the police department to set up?
Should I call tomorrow?
That's your decision, sir. Okay, but
yeah.
we certainly, you have made us aware of an issue and a perhaps problematic situation.
Thank you.
So we need to hear from the manager.
Like a building
we need to get them in here.
No, just that we meet there at 12:30 and or 12:45 and we do a building check together, and I'll be there as well. I don't mind doing that.
I don't know if you have to be.
Well, I probably don't have to be, but I wouldn't mind seeing it for myself.
I know the last time that you were here, I believe in the same meeting where we did the change of manager from Sebastian to Benson.
Yes.
And Benson.
In hindsight, that was the worst thing I ever did when Sebastian, you know, I'm looking back at it now,
right.
4 months ago.
Yeah.
Because he was very convincing.
Well, sure. And
he's
I
recall neighbor.
At the last
nice guy.
At the meeting with Benson that he did go on record as saying he want he's
nothing
eager to work
changed.
With you and
nothing.
So at this point it makes sense to call him back in.
Well, I mean, is he still a Sebastian?
Benson.
Okay.
Sebastian's
yeah.
no
gone.
Longer employed
yeah.
by that group.
Yeah.
It's not much. All right, so.
Thank you.
I guess our course of action is going to contact him and ask him to appear before our next meeting.
Thank you so much.
We'll see if we can get a vote.
I feel like things are getting done now. It's a start.
Yeah.
It's a start, yeah.
It's just so close, their music,
yeah.
their PA system just goes, it's nothing but old brick and it goes, it stops nothing.
Right.
Thank you.
You bet.
Thank you.
Thank you. So, I guess to continue on the conversation.
Yes.
The fair wage.
Yeah.
I just want you to know that I gave the clerk a copy of the council order
okay.
that deals with the council licenses. You can look at that after the supper.
So, if somebody's in violation, I guess this is a question for you. If someone is to be found in violation of wage law, that has been generated by a complaint of an employee.
Generally.
Is that correct? Okay. So, an employee would have complained to.
Usually
who would they have
the
complained?
Attorney General's office.
Okay. And then if the Attorney General has followed through on it, they would find that there was in fact a violation or not, either way.
Right. Or the employee could hire a private lawyer who would make a wage claim in court.
Okay.
And that's the state, but we also have FALSA, so I'm like,
right.
if it's a large enough employer, if they have a certain volume of business in a particular year, then you're talking about having to make a labor complaint, a wage and hour complaint to the federal
right.
Folks. I really just have one, and I appreciate how much thought has gone into this, and I'm not not terribly sympathetic to it. Certainly have seen how difficult it is for people to pursue complaints effectively over the years. But what I'm concerned about is with the bond or an insurance binder, and there's cost associated with that. I just don't want to get us in a situation where the ABCC says we are, in effect, putting an additional cost on the issuance of a license that they don't agree with. All I want is them to say to Cindy, and that's all I need, that, hey, Boston and Cambridge and all these other folks are doing this, and we don't have problems with them, we don't have problems with you. I just don't want some lawyer coming before us and trying to do a divide and conquer based on that. So that's yeah, that would be before I make any final decision. I guess I would like that information.
So essentially what that would be, because if anyone that came into the city or lived here their whole life, but they wanted to start a new business and they came before us for a common vic or any license, and they didn't have proof of fair wage, they would have to buy that insurance?
No.
Or they would not, only
no.
if they're in
they
violation?
No,
like
they would fill out an affidavit, and assuming that the applicant truthfully filled out the application, if that person or that entity had been found within the last 3 years to be in violation, then the wage bond or insurance kicks in. Otherwise, all it is filling out an affidavit.
So we're trusting that they're being honest in their affidavit, and that's the, there's no other, so it's not, nothing's being asked of us to look further than.
This is not an investigatory body, we're not asking you to do any investigation, look behind the affidavit at all.
Pretty much what we're being asked to do is to make a motion to approve an affidavit that's similar to, you know, have one developed, just like workers' comp, but just to have them fill out with all the information that would be checked. And then.
And with follow-up.
Further follow-up, we can find out whether or not we can even do that, according to the ABCC, as far as the insurance and the bonds.
Yeah, that's my concern, that we not basically adopt a scheme that someone is going to be able to trip. Yeah, exactly. I mean, I want us to be able to put something in place that is going to hold water, mm-hmm. and we're not going to end up with people playing games as some people
do. So am I right in thinking that we could make a motion to do this approval of making an affidavit to work for that, and then
pending the ABCC.
Everything with the ABCC as far as the insurance portion, as far as us requiring that, or is that insurance bond even, you know, is that required through our body, or is that, you know, the mayor's office and everyone else with the executive orders?
No, that's us requiring people to basically buy a bond or to buy some insurance. So that's why I'm saying it's a cost. This is my suggestion. I think we're all, it seems like we're on the same page as far as where we want to end up. I would like that, shall we say, reassurance from the ABCC, and then I would think at the next meeting we could go ahead and adopt the total scheme if we get that assurance.
Right. I would, my preference would be that it be, we know for certain that it's not going to crumble moving forward and that we do it right straight out of the gate. But I do have one other question. In terms of the wage bonds, is there any other entity that would impose a business to have a wage bond for this purpose? Is there any other, in the course of opening a business or renewing their insurance or anything else, would there be another avenue for, apart from what Elaine just alluded to, of a license commission imposing a wage bond on a business, is there anybody else who could impose a wage bond for this reason?
I suppose if a prospective business owner needs to come to you for a license, that needs to go to the council for a license.
But for like insurance purposes or something like that, there wouldn't be any discovery on that end. Okay.
No. Not that I'm aware of.
Okay.
So could we, Elaine, is it possible to go forward with a motion for the affidavit?
I don't think so. I would table this until the next meeting and ask, whatever.
That's fine.
You know, really an oral representation that Cindy takes down. I don't care how as long as we have proof, as long as she said, because we've had some communication snafus with the ABCC in the past, as long as Cindy emails back a confirmation as to what she was told, I do believe we've gotten two or three different readings of the same rule and regulation.
So we don't even have to make a motion.
Am I drafting? I would draft one and send it to you.
Well, we're not there.
I don't think so.
The language she's proposing is that we talk to ABCC first, make sure that everything's good with the money and so on and so forth, and approve the whole lot next meeting, depending on what ABCC responses.
I would think in the six other communities that
have these resolutions, it should be a quick.
I think it should be something we can quickly get.
We just want to do it right.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Right. So, does that need a motion for pulling on that? Or?
I would just make a motion to table the discussion of this item and put it as the first item on the next meeting.
Thank you very much.
And thank you so much for coming. Thanks.
Thank you, guys.
All right. That being said, I make a motion to adjourn.
Meetings, do you?
I'll second that.
All in favor?
Aye, aye, aye.